In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can set alarms and timers with the iPhone. This is all done through the clock app. In addition to setting alarms and timers, we also have a stopwatch and a world clock. Now, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at how we set alarms and timers and more with the clock app on the iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. As I mentioned, this is all done through the clock app. So let's go ahead and open up the clock app. And let's first take a look at alarms. You're going to see down at the bottom we have a tab bar here. What we want to do is we want to go over here to alarms. So these are all the alarms that I have on my iPhone. So I have about 5 different alarms here. To turn an existing alarm on or off, all we have to do is just tap on the little slider here. So let's go ahead and tap on it. You're going to see it turns green and the time gets a little bit brighter. To turn it back off, we just tap on it again and it turns it off. Pretty simple. If we want to edit it, let's just go ahead and tap on this one here. To edit it, tap on it. I can change the time. I can also set if I want it to repeat. Let's go ahead and see how that works. Tap on repeat, and then from here I just tap on which ones I want it to be. So now on the weekdays only, what it's going to do is it's going to use this alarm. If it's not on a weekday, it will not use that alarm or turn that alarm on. To go back, we just go back. I can also name it. This is kind of nice to see what the alarm is for. And then if you want to change the sound, you can do that on an alarm by alarm basis. So you can change the sound for each alarm. So then when an alarm goes off and it's a specific sound, you'll know what that alarm is for. That's why you may want to do that. And then our last option here is snooze. We're able to turn this on and off. So if you do not want to have the ability to snooze it once the alarm goes off, you are probably familiar with snooze. Tap on it 9 minutes later. What it'll do is it'll go off again. If you don't want to do that, if you don't want to have snooze, all you have to do is just tap on it to turn that off. And then if we want to delete the alarm, we can do that as well. When you are done, you just tap on save and it'll save any changes that you made. So that's how we can edit an alarm. I can also, before we take a look at how we create new alarms, if I wanted to delete an alarm from here, I can also just swipe to the left and you're going to see I can delete that. I'm going to turn this alarm off. Now, how do we create an alarm? Well, basically what we do is we just go up to the plus here and then I go and set the time, repeat, label it, set the sound, and if I want to use snooze. When you are done, you just tap on save and it'll create that alarm. My favorite way to create alarms is actually through Siri though. So I'm going to go to the home screen and I'm going to press and hold on the sleep wake button. This is how I get to Siri. And I'm going to create an alarm. So let's just create one for 3 p.m. So now I just press and hold. Set an alarm for 3 p.m. And now you're going to see I have this alarm here, and it's set for 3 p.m. And it did add it to the clock app. So I just tap on clock, and we can see we have that alarm there, and it is turned on. Tap on it to turn it off. Now, all of these are just basic alarms. They turn on at a specific time. You can set a snooze, and they turn off. But you're going to see that we also have a sleep wake-up alarm. What is this one? Well, this one is designed to help you sleep better. Basically, what it'll do is it'll tell you how much time you're sleeping. So if we look here, you're going to see that it says, if I go to bed at 10:30 and I set it to wake me up at 6:30, that will basically give me 8 hours worth of sleep. Let's say I wanted to have 9 hours worth of sleep. Well, all I have to do is just drag this over until this says 9 or until this says 7:30, however you want to look at it. So I'm just going to drag this and move it over. So now I just drag that and you're going to see that both of those times are changing. So let's just go with 9 hours here. And now it's going to wake me up at 7:30 if I go to bed at 10:30. I could do the same thing here. And if I just want to move the entire dial, I want to keep this at 9 hours, what I can do is I can drag this area here, not from the edge, but I drag in that area there, and it's going to take that whole dial there and move it. So now I can say I'm going to go to bed at 12:30. I'm a late nighter. Let's just go 12:45. I still want to have 9 hours worth of sleep. If we look here, you're going to see that it is going to wake me up at 9:45. So you can just take this little area here once you set your hours of sleep. You're also able to set if you want to turn it on or off, and if you want to be able to snooze it. So you have a lot of the same options as before. But like I said, with this one, it's a little special here. What you're able to do with it as well is just set when you want to go to sleep and how much sleep you want to have. So it's a little special alarm in there. I'm going to cancel this. So that's our alarms. Now let's take a look at our timers. You're going to see I have timer down here in the tab bar. I tap on that, and I have my different timers here. Now what I'm able to do is create multiple timers. This works great for something like cooking. Maybe you're cooking something and you have separate timers for different things that you're cooking. Well, all you have to do to start a timer is just tap on the play button here, or you could go to your recents, and if you wanted to create a new one, you tap on the plus, and then you can set what the timer is. You can also label it, which is really nice for when you're cooking. What is this timer for? Is it for something in the oven? You could put that in there. And then you can also set what you want it to do when the timer ends. What type of sound is it? So when I tap on this, what I'm able to do is change the sound. So then based on the sound, you're able to know what you need to do. Let's say you're cooking again. Let's go back. I have a number of presets that I can choose, and I can choose from recents. Now again, I'm going to cancel here. The way that I generally use timers is through Siri. So I'm going to go to the home screen, and now I press and hold on the sleep-wake button. I'm going to set a timer for 12 minutes. Set a timer for 12 minutes. And now we can see we have a timer for 12 minutes. I know that in 12 minutes, this will go off and I can pull that frozen pizza out of the oven, right? That's typically what you use a 12-minute timer for. At least I do. I tap on the dynamic island here to open it up. And now what I'm able to do is pause that timer. So that's how we can use timers. If we want to delete one, it's just swipe to the left and I can delete that. Now the clock app also has a couple of the other features. We have a stopwatch here. Pretty basic how this works. Tap on it, and I can start the stopwatch. I can lap, and when I lap, what it's going to do is add the times down here. So I'm going to hit the lap, and you're going to see that it's adding times there. And then if I want to stop it, I just tap on stop, and it stops it. To reset it, to clear it, you just tap on reset, and it resets it. Pretty simple. And then our last one here is a world clock. With the world clock, what we're able to do is see times around the world. And what we're able to do is modify these cities. We can change them. We can reorder them. As an example, I give a presentation to a group over in Anchorage on a regular basis. So I would like to know what time it is over in Anchorage. Well, Anchorage isn't in here. If I tap on the plus, I'm able to search for Anchorage. And now we have Anchorage here. I want to move that up towards the top. We tap on edit. And now I can take this and drag it up. And it's up towards the top. I can also delete any of these by tapping on the red button. Or what I can do is I can just swipe and I can delete that. So that is how we can add alarms or manage our alarms as well as timers on the iPhone. This is all done through the clock app. The clock app also has a stopwatch as well as a world clock. Generally, what I will do, I will create alarms with Siri. So my list of alarms is actually quite long, but it works pretty well. And same thing with timers. I put a pizza in the oven, just set a timer for such and such time, 12 minutes, and then it'll go off after 12 minutes to remind me to pull that pizza out. So that is how we can use alarms and timers on the iPhone. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video, you can subscribe to my channel, you can share it with your friends and family. You also may want to check out danstutorials.com. In addition to having more videos, I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple genius, and I have classes or host classes and webinars on a regular basis. So how can you help support my efforts? Well, it is a membership-based site. When you become a member, I take out all of the ads from the videos. You have access to that AI assistant modeled after an Apple genius, and you have access to my classes and webinars. But also you're also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some large organization. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.